Hey guys, my name is David Kwon, and this is a video in which I'm going to talk about social work. How useful is a bachelor's degree in social work? How useful is a master's degree in social work? So this is just kind of me talking about that. If you're watching this video and you pretty much already know what social work is, and you have a good idea, this video is a total waste of time for you. It will not add to your knowledge of what social work is if you already know about it. This video is simply to just address a lot of the comments I've been getting on my video, I now owe Citibank $105,000. This video, in that sense, is a long time coming. Because a lot of the comments, it repeats a lot of the same things. It asks about my current loan situation, which I did talk about in another video. Of course, that was posted a year ago, and the situation has definitely changed till then, but I don't feel like making another video, making like number adjustments. That's not what I want to do. Everything I pretty much wanted to say about my loan situation, I've already said that in the videos that I posted. Another thing was, why did you choose NYU? Why did you choose social work? Again, that's something I made the video for pretty recently. Like, is it recently? Really recently? I don't know. But I've made that video. I've uploaded that. One thing I've yet to address, and I will now address in this video, is a lot of comments that really diss social work, not knowing what it is, why it's useful. Some people post negative things about social work, knowing what it is. I respect that, I guess. I disagree with it, but I respect it. You know, you at least know what the hell social work is. So, you know, but majority of people, it seems like there is such lack of awareness or lack of knowledge about this major. Sometimes I actually meet people in real life, and of course this question comes up, you know, what did you major in college? And I say, you know, I majored in social work. That's what my bachelor's degree is. And they have this like blank, puzzled expression on their faces, like, what is that? So that's what this video is for. If you already know about social work, again, this video is a total waste of your time. Do something more productive. For those who don't know what it is and would like to like know what it is, and also what does it do? What does it mean to have a bachelor's in social work or master's in social work? This is that video. It's going to be very basic. I'm not going to go into extreme detail, but it will at least give you a better sense of what social work is, so that you don't end up like one of those people making really, really stupid comments about social work in my videos. Because there's so many of those, and I don't understand why. So, first thing, what is social work? And this is a question I didn't even know when I applied to NYU. And I talked about this in another video of mine. I applied to NYU, they have 12 schools, or about 12. I think they at another school, whatever. But NYU has a very specific school called Gallatin School of Individualized Study. It's a school where you can make a major. You can create a major that you think doesn't exist. So it's really cool. I applied to there saying, I want to create a major where I mix research on history and sociology, and mix that with volunteerism activism. So make it a hands-on kind of historical research. Applied to Gallatin. A month later, NYU emailed me back saying, you should consider social work because that's pretty much what you're suggesting. And in a way, they were right. Social work, in a way, is becoming aware of how society functions. So sociology, psychology, it all fits into it. History, you try to have this historical knowledge, sociological knowledge, psychological knowledge of people and environment. And with that knowledge, you try to do something that solves or mitigates at least the social problems such as homelessness, poverty, terrible justice system in the prison, re-entry from prison, school mental health issues, all these myriad health issues that are not solved directly by the medical profession or by scientists or anything, that's up for grabs for social workers. And that's what they're trained to do. They're trained to use this historical, sociological, psychological knowledge to use that hands-on to mitigate or solve these social problems. That's what social work is, in general. Where does it lead? So, I have a bachelor's in social work, and it depends. Different states have different laws and different licensures, different licensure processes that make your BSW work different in different states. I know I just kind of worded that really, that was really bad wording. But what it means is, if I go to a state like Tennessee, with my BSW, I can, I'd have to go undergo an interview and obtain my license. But with my BSW, I could be a social worker. In New York State, which I'm living in now, I can't. BSW doesn't really mean much in this state because I need an MSW. So in different states, in really big states such as California, Illinois, New York, really big states with really big cities, the licensure, of course, is going to be even tougher. The criteria for being able to be a certified social worker is going to be tougher to obtain. That makes sense. Now, what do you do as a social worker? There are many fields in which you can use your social work. The highest paying jobs as social workers are counselors and private like psychiatrists. You may not realize this, but a lot of your therapists, about 50% or so, have social work degrees. So you can be a private therapist, or you can actually have an MSW and go into, doctorate in psychology in order to become like a psychiatrist and prescribe medicine and dosage and stuff. So that's one pathway you can go. That's the clinical path. You can be hospital social workers, and those are the people who they're supposed to. This doesn't happen very effectively in many places, but what they're supposed to do is they're supposed to kind of help the patient with the extra, what the medical field doesn't do. So for example, a nurse will treat you for your injuries, a doctor, prescribes you medicine. But what about if you're, maybe you're 60 years old, you just got in a car accident, you came to the hospital cured you, now you need to go back home, but there's no one to drive you home, you have no family members, those are social issues. That's when hospital social workers come in. They deal with those kinds of social issues. They also deal with the people, who come into hospitals. After staying in the hospital, they become depressed or they start exhibiting mental health conditions. Again, that's where social workers come in. Social work, I think, the best way I can describe a social worker in very general terms is to act as a person who links people in need with the services they need. They are this linkage. And so often they refer people to agencies and to experts who can help them, but they need this link, and that's what social workers often do. Sometimes they are direct service providers, such as school counselors, guidance counselors, school social workers. They can provide that direct service. Workers in the homeless shelter, case managers, that can be a social worker or a social worker in the homeless shelter, social worker in prisons. That's kind of, like I said, many fields. Some social work some people with MSW don't necessarily go into social work, but they go into something that is nonprofit, such as a CEO of a homeless shelter organization. A CEO of, you can become like an owner, co-founder of a nonprofit organization. That's certainly within the realm of a social work degree. So those are the many ways in which somebody can utilize their social work profession. Now, I only know really specifically about New York State. In order to be a certified social worker in any given setting, what you need in New York City is you know, you don't need a bachelor's, you don't need a BSW. BSW helps you get your MSW a lot more easily. That's the purpose of the BSW, which is the reason why I got a BSW, and now I'm going to enter into graduate school to get my MSW. Once you have your MSW, that doesn't really finish, you know, that doesn't mean you're done. You still have to get an experience as a social worker, supervised. You're supervised for 3 years, and after 3 years, you get your social work license. And with that license, you can finally start actually practicing certified social work job. So that's pretty much what I have to say for now. If any of you guys have any questions about what social work is and any questions about social work, let me know in the comment section, PM me or whatever. But I just think it's really weird to me that I encounter all these comments on my videos in which people are just so unknowledgeable about what social work is. That just really strikes me. Some people have been commenting that it's a liberal arts degree. It's not. It's not a liberal arts degree. It's a helping profession degree. Maybe not as, you know, the criteria is not as maybe severe, you know, extreme or as rigorous as a nursing degree, but it's in that field. It's not a liberal arts degree. I want to make that clear. In order to graduate with an MSW, you need to have performed an internship. Liberal arts degree does not require internship, to my knowledge. So that's a clear distinction that I want to make. I think I'm done talking. I talked about 11 minutes and 40 seconds now, so I'm going to finish talking now. But yeah, any questions, feel free to comment. I hope this helped you, you know more about what social work is. Cheers.